SBS acknowledges the traditional custodians of country and their connections and continuous care for the skies, lands and waterways across Australia.
You're listening to Australia Explained, an SBS audio podcast helping you navigate life in Australia.
Becoming an Australian citizen is an exciting and rewarding experience for many migrants. But to achieve citizenship, you must first pass the Australian Citizenship Test. The test measures your knowledge of Australia's history, culture, values, and political system.
When clients come to me, I straight away encourage them to start preparing for it. And part of the preparation is listen to the news in English.
I'm your host, Maram Smail. And in this episode, we'll provide you with some tips and expert advice to help you prepare for the Australian Citizenship Test.
It became apparent very quickly that people needed support and help with preparing for the citizenship test and to understand how important it is to have citizenship here for the security that it offers.
Australia is a diverse and multicultural nation, with over 270 ancestors represented. It boasts one of the world's oldest continuous cultures and has welcomed nearly 7 million migrants since 1945. There are several ways to apply for the Australian citizenship. You must also meet a specific set of criteria before applying. Conferral and descent are the most common ways of applying for citizenship. Migration lawyer Eva Abdelmasih has assisted hundreds of people in gaining Australian citizenship. She says the most important criterion is to meet the residence requirement.
The residence requirement has specific criteria. One is that you need to have been residing in Australia on any kind of visa, as long as it's a lawful status, for the last 4 years. And you should not have had absence during this 4 years of more than 12 months. And in particular, the last 12 months, the last year needs to be on a permanent residency, not temporary, and no absence more than 90 days within the last 12 months.
Besides meeting the residence requirement, applicants for Australian citizenship over 18 must demonstrate good character, defined as enduring moral qualities. In addition to plan to reside in Australia or stay connected while abroad, have a basic knowledge of the English language, and have knowledge about Australia and what it means to be an Australian citizen. To assist this, most applicants will sit the citizenship test.
If they are an adult from the age of 18 to 59, they need to show that they have a basic knowledge of English. They will need to sit to have an interview and sit for the citizenship test.
If you are eligible to become an Australian citizen and are preparing for the citizenship test, you must do your homework. Ms. Eva explains.
The Australian citizenship test is about checking the understanding of what it means to be an Australian citizen. So we know about Australia and its people, the symbols about Australia, the democratic beliefs, rights and liberties, how the government is formed, how is law made in Australia, understanding and showing commitment to Australian values, which are mainly based on freedom, respect and equality.
The Australian citizenship test consists of 20 multiple choice questions. It covers various topics such as the Australian symbols, historical events, government structure, citizenship rights and responsibilities. Miss Eva again.
5 of these 20 multiple choice questions are based on Australian values, and you're not allowed to have any mistakes in any of them. So the pass mark for the test is 75%, which means it allows for some mistakes. But in the section about Australian values, no mistakes are allowed. If you lose one question or if you fail on one question, that means you fail the whole test.
The Department of Home Affairs website recommends studying from the official Citizenship Test resource booklet, which is called Australian Citizenship, Our Common Bond. The booklet is available in 40 languages, and you can also listen to the content through a podcast link provided on the website.
Australian Citizenship, Our Common Bond. Episode 1, Introduction.
All the information needed for the test is in the Our Common Bond booklet. You must understand it thoroughly and take notes to help you memorize it. You can also take an online practice test on one of the many websites offering free citizenship test practice that simulates the actual test. Ms. Eva says many phone applications can be more accessible and easier to navigate than accessing website links from computers.
These phone apps, I find them very helpful. I always encourage my clients to download them and do them, you know, every night, just spend half an hour. There's also, like on YouTube, there is videos about it.
The citizenship test will quiz you on significant Australian events, and it often includes the contributions of Indigenous and multicultural Australians. The test is only available in English, so you must understand the language well. You can practice reading and familiarize yourself with the essential vocabulary to help you understand the questions.
When clients come to me, I straight away encourage them to start preparing for it. And part of the preparation is listen to the news in English, read newspapers in English, do the practice test at least once a week. Because when we lodge today, they don't get the test straight away. There is a good gap of 6 to 9 months.
Ms. Eva also shares some common mistakes or pitfalls that applicants should avoid while sitting the test. She advises applicants to read questions carefully, stay within time limits, and avoid rushing to click the answer.
We're given an option to do the test 3 times, but after the 3rd time, there is no option. It will be refused, and then we'll have to apply a fresh application.
If you need assistance navigating the study material on the Department of Home Affairs website, and help improving your English, you can contact one of the many local community organizations for help. For example, SidWest Multicultural Services in New South Wales and Southern Migrant and Refugee Centre in Victoria offer citizenship test preparation classes and resources to help aspiring citizens prepare for the test. These organizations often have experienced instructors who can provide guidance and support throughout the process. Vicky Hine from SidWest explains how their courses have helped many new migrants prepare for the citizenship test.
In bringing people together to learn about their new country and how to navigate through services and all the kinds of things you need to know when you're settling in a new country, it became apparent very quickly that people needed support and help with preparing for the citizenship test and to understand how important it is to have citizenship here for the security that it offers.
This course is open to migrants from all backgrounds.
Pretty much it's anybody who's in the eligibility for settlement services, which is like the first 5 years of your arrival in Australia. You don't have to be a refugee. It's anybody, any type of migrant.
SidWest established the first citizenship class in Western Sydney in 2014. Since then, Ms. Hine says that hundreds of clients have successfully passed their tests and got citizenship certificates.
They go through each of the questions and they talk about it. They would learn some history. We also go on social outings as groups, explain the layout of the land. You know, we might go up to Katoomba and at the same time talk about the history of Australia being opened up by explorers. It's working your way through all the questions, fully understanding them, so that you fully understand what it means to participate as an Australian citizen.
Beyond memorizing facts and figures, embracing Australian culture will enhance your understanding of the nation and its values.
Join social groups like the type that we coordinate. You get to speak to other people from different countries, different languages, and you're all practicing your English together in a casual social setting. You know, it's about the barbecue, the picnic, learning about the flora and the fauna that might be in that park.
If you found this information helpful, please share it with others who may also be embarking on their citizenship journey. Thank you for listening to this episode of Australia Explained, written, produced and hosted by me, Maram Smail. Australia Explained Managing Editor is Rosa Germian. Until next time.
This was an SBS audio podcast. For more Australia Explained stories, visit sbs.com.au/Australia Explained.